Well, I just heard the news today. It seems my life is gonna change. I close my eyes, begin to pray. Then tears of joy stream down my face.
Your dad was waiting outside, pacing back and forth in the hallway, and I got the privilege of catching you in a sterile drape, taking you over to the warmer, and drying you off, and giving you a little blow-by oxygen. You did beautifully. You were crying, and Brent was there, one of the respiratory therapists, who went out in the hallway and told your daddy that you were crying, and he was really happy to hear that.
We were kind of a little scared with the urgency of the nature in which we first met you.
It was scary when we came into the delivery room.
That was the first we knew about you guys, was you were coming in with massive bleeding, and that's all we knew.
We were kind of waiting for you guys. We had everything all set up.
We were kind of expecting worst case scenario.
And your mommy was still awake. We could only see mommy's heart rate. And so everybody was nervous a little bit. And, you know, very quickly, everybody moved very quickly to get you out of mommy's tummy and make sure that you and your mom were okay. And so we were very pleasantly surprised at how well you did. We were really happy about that.
We're the arms wide open. I'll show you everything. Oh yeah.
My name's Marianne Guyman, and I'm one of the nurses that was there when Tyler was born, and he had quite a start coming into this world. He had to have a little help breathing, but he caught on real fast and did well.
I know Tyler because I took care of him when he was 3 days old, and he was still on the ventilator, and he was having some bleeding in his ET tube, and that was really scary for your mom and dad, Tyler, but you were very, very brave, and you hung in there for them, and you got better. We gave you some blood, your bleeding stopped. And by that following Monday, we were able to get you off the ventilator. He had just a very wonderful, even though he was really sick and didn't feel good, he had a very wonderful disposition. He was a very calm, cool, he wasn't crabby, he wasn't cranky, he just had a very wonderful disposition the whole time that he was there, when he could have just been needing all kinds of medication to calm him down or to take the pain away. He didn't need any of that. He just was hung in there and just kind of let it all happen and let himself heal, and he did a great job. He was a trooper. He was a tough little guy.
You're a child in my head. You haven't walked yet. Your first words have yet to be said. But I swear you'll be blessed.
So I'm Elizabeth Silverman, and I met Tyler on the night he was born, and he scared me a little bit, but he doesn't scare me anymore.
And I didn't know his name was Tyler, but I just knew that he was cute, and I knew he was a fighter. And I just think that he has the best mom and dad in the world, and I wish him all the luck.
Taking care of him a lot since he's been here. In fact, it seems like most of the time that I'm working, I'm taking care of him. Anyway, he's come a long way. He's doing great. Well, I always remember the people that I get close to, you know, certain people you just kind of bond with, and that's kind of the way it's been with me and Jody. So we talk a lot and just feel real comfortable with each other. And plus, she bought me a coffee card, what can I say?
Why do you say that?
Yes, he waits for his turn for the feeding. He doesn't scream.
He's very gentle nature. Yeah, he's a good boy. He has a very calm, sweet nature about him.
He knows how to cooperate with me if I'm busy with other babies.
I think the thing that stood out about him, he just had a great personality. I know it sounds corny, but I just from the get-go, he just had a good personality. Yeah, he would be cranky at times, but he's a pretty laid-back baby, I have to say. He's a Southern California guy, I think, so.
Oh no, is that too stereotypical?
I need you before I'm too old to have and to hold, to walk with you and walk you grow and know that you're blessed, and you, you'll be blessed. You have the best, I promise you that. I pick a star from the sky.
Here to see. Hey, no, no, sit here and talk to me. I'm going to talk to you for a minute. Who are we here to see?
Baby Tyler.
That's right.
And who's holding baby Tyler right now?
Mommy.
And who's holding the camera?
I'm Dada.
And who loves you?
Dada. Hey, can you go show us? All right, go show us where baby Tyler's Mimi is.
Okay.
Baby Tyler's Mimi. Let's leave this blanket here, okay?
He needs it. He's cold. Baby Tyler's cold.
Right here, okay? I'll picture.
Hey, is he your baby brother?
Is he your baby brother?
I'll see.
Okay, can you do any more drawings?
My undies.
Those are undies?
That's her.
He doesn't know. He doesn't seem that little anymore.
No, no.
No, Mom.
He is.
Annalie, you know what? If you don't listen, you go to timeout. Okay?
I know.
Don't touch. Touch his foot.
You can only touch his foot. Thank you.
Hard to believe you have a son?
Yes.
Meanwhile, Annalie Luke, why are you so stinking busy? A 2-year-old in the NICU.
It's really not the optimal situation.
Well, I don't know how to explain it, but I know the words will hardly do. Miracles, the signs and wonders aren't enough for me to prove to you.
Don't you know I've always loved you? Even before there was time. Though you turn away, I tell you still, don't you know I've always loved you? And I always will.
So I'm Casey. It's Larry. I was Tyler's OT.
Which is
occupational therapist. So what we work on in the NICU is teaching Tyler how to feed and grow. And he's done a marvelous job of that.
Your boyfriend.
Boyfriend. And no, I'm not weird or anything like that, but he just was because he was just, I would always check on him, even on the weekends, once I call up, like, all right, how's my boyfriend doing? We always have the one
before there was time. Though you turn away, I tell you still, don't you know I've always loved you, and I always will.
He can thank a lot of people, but mostly he can thank himself because it's him. He did all the hard work. He's the one that helped make himself better. We just kind of helped him a little bit along the way.
I'm going to always remember it just because we really were prepared for, the worst, and it was really the best scenario. I mean, he was just a whole fighter, you know? We're both okay.
Is this here?
September 19th. Been in the NICU for 6 weeks.
6 weeks?
Mm-hmm. 6 weeks, all through the day. 6 weeks in one day. Haley is our discharge nurse. She's back.
The days are sure to come. And when you smile, be sure to smile wide. And don't let them know that they have won. And when you walk, walk with pride. Don't show the hurt inside, because the pain will soon be gone.
You're welcome, have fun with them.
And when you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean blue. When you dream, it might come true. When you dream, dream big. And when you laugh, be sure to laugh out loud, 'cause it will carry all your cares away. And when you see the beauty all around and in yourself, and it will help you feel okay. And when you pray and pray for strength to help you carry on, and when the troubles come your way. And when you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean blue. 'Cause when you dream, it might come true. And when you dream, dream big.
You have a lot of people that love you in your life, and we're really glad that you came into this world.
Great parents. Yeah. Love your parents.
Anyway, we wish you lots of luck in your new life and your new family.
He's going to grow into a strong, fine young man. He's going to bring lots of joy to his mom and dad. I promise.
Good luck. Enjoy your life. Because it'll be fun. You've got great and fun parents and a fun little sister.
That you help you carry on when the troubles come your way. And when you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean blue. 'Cause when you dream, it might come true. When you dream, dream.